All right. Yes. Okay, there he is. I want to start rapping, but I won't.
I don't have that talent and skill. My name is Sheena Wright, and I'm the first deputy mayor under Mayor Eric Adams. And I'm so excited that we have been celebrating hip hop's 50th anniversary this year. Yay! Yes. Many of us are. I am a child of hip hop. I happen to have been born and raised in the Boogie Down, right? That's right. That's where it was born. Brooklyn. I know they try to say other things, but it was the Bronx, the birthplace. And I absolutely remembered the jams in the park and really hip hop being the soundtrack for our lives. And the fact that it is a global phenomena that has really disrupted fashion, business, and everything else coming from New York makes all the sense in the world. And I also remember the female rappers, right?
That's
Commissioner
right.
Combo, Roxanne Shanté, The Queen, Remy Ma, Salt and Pepper. They gave voice to women's confidence and empowerment, and we are grateful for them. So 50 years later, hip hop, the global phenomenon that it is, a soundtrack for change and snapshot into the everyday struggles and triumphs for so many. So what we're doing today is really kicking off a series of concerts and community activation that are gonna be phenomenal. And I'm so grateful for all of the partners and the leaders who have put this together. So I'm first going to introduce Jocelyn Cooper, the co-founder of It's All Black Music, to come up and tell us a little bit about what we are going to be doing. Jocelyn?
All right, thank you.
Hello, everybody. On behalf of It's All Black Music, and as a child from Brooklyn.
Brooklyn.
Who honestly had the Sugar Hill Gang perform in my elementary school lunchroom, and as someone who has been a part of hip hop, I signed Cash Money Records, who have spawned so many global superstars. I cannot believe that we are here at this moment, at this time. I'm so excited to be a part of this incredible event series and these incredible shows. And I just want to give a special shout out to our partners, Universal, particularly Katina Bynum, at Vic Resnick, Adidas, Sony Corporation, Certified, and of course the mayor for making all of this happen. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Jocelyn. Next up, I have the immense pleasure of introducing a legend and a leader, KRS-One.
Yes, right.
I'm not gonna say that I'm off guard here in that sense. I will say this, take a look at the organization of New York City right now. How ironic it is that it's hip hop that's bringing the city together. If we could get one thing out of this, look at the unity of our city, how we're shining right now on behalf of hip hop. We should do this more often, you guys, because it seems like this is, it takes sometimes a movement like hip hop to bring us all together, to have different factions of New York City talking to one another. You know, I did a walk out in the Bronx, just looking at one of the locations that we're gonna announce to you today. And out there you saw sanitation, fire, police, highway. And when we were coming up, this was unheard of. Hip hop as fire chief, hip hop as police chief, hip hop as mayor? Come on, Deputy Mayor B-Girl. I mean, this is a literal dream come true, and I'm just proud to be part of this. And we're rocking all mics. We're rocking all microphones. Mayor Eric Adams, y'all.
My man, KRS-One, you know, he has been a legend for so many years. Listen, did you do any, did you drop any beats?
Nothing. I was getting ready to kick a freestyle.
And you know, David, you have to, Sheena, you have to hear how he could put a beat together like instant. Come on, can you do a little something for us?
I don't know what advertisement we have to talk. What do you want?
Talk about how great I am as a man. You gotta get on the mic.
Let me tell you what it is. I'm off the top. This is what we call real hip hop off the block. I'm telling you right now, because back in the day, there was a mayor called Mayor Koch that didn't know his way. He had us looking. He said war on graffiti, had us running all up and down the whole city. But 20 years later, guess who popped up? Real hip hop. And you know what's up.
You know, and going back in time, I don't know if it was, it probably was in the 90s, KRS-One did a beat called Black Cops. Black Cops, they don't even pay you a lot. And what people thought we were back, I don't know if it was the Guardians or 100 Blacks in Law Enforcement, but we really identified with what he was saying. And we reached out to the brother and said, you know, can we sit down and hear some ideas? And we had a good conversation on where he was bringing that music and that song from, that beat from. And I just watched him over the years. He continued to make the connectivity between the industry and how the real life incidents that our young people are going through. We needed him back then in the 90s, but we need you now more than ever right now to really bridge the gap, you know? And so I wanna thank the first hip hop first deputy mayor, Sheena Wright. You know, and the first hip hop cultural affairs commissioner, you know, Lori Cumbo. You know, and the whole crew. We got a couple of firsts up here, you know, who are doing their thing. You know, and think about it. August 1973, in an apartment at 1520 Segwit Avenue in the Bronx, a back to school jam hosted by brother and sister Clive and Cindy Campbell, featuring DJ Kool Herc, Spill Outside to the Street. That night, hip hop and block party was born. For 50 years, think about it, 50 years, who would have thought hip hop would have brought us this far, from partying on the block to standing here at City Hall honoring these legends as the mayor of the city of New York? We've come a long way. And even as we think about Drake, we started from the bottom, now we're here. Now we're here. From the Boogie Down Bronx, Wu-Tang and Staten Island, to the pioneers in Queens, to the storytellers in Brooklyn and the clubs in Manhattan, it was told the story of New York City and our people in the inner cities. It just really amplified the voices of everyday young people, that artistic energy of taking what they were experiencing and turning it into an international phenomenon. And you know, just standing here with my brother now and talking about it just really brings chills to those of us who use those songs to inspire us. I can remember over and over again, as I prepared Dean to study for an exam, I would play Fight the Power, you know? And to paraphrase A Tribe Called Quest, we are going to check the rhyme this summer with the ultimate block parties to celebrate 50 years of hip hop. In partnership with It's All Black Music Presents and Lisa Project NYC, we're going to host free block parties and activations and create hip hop murals across the city. New York should be celebrating a genre that we created. It gave birth here. We raised it on the streets of New York, and it has gone out to cascade throughout the entire globe. Again, these free events, they are also free to the city because take my hat off to Universal, Adidas, Sony, Certified, the Recording Academy. They have donated talent to support all the parties and activation. These events will bring important DJs and artists to our neighborhoods to make our blocks hot. Artists such as legendary KRS-One, who I am just really proud to have him here with us today, and other great pioneers in this industry. These were unbelievable leaders, and we really want to lift them up. And finally, there will be a free drone light show showing the iconic images of hip hop thanks to Pixis drones. Now, many people didn't realize that on 4th of July, for the first time, we had drones. And when Macy came to me and said that they told them that we can't have drones in the city of New York, I said, this is not a city of no, this is a city of yes. And we had drones, and we will continue to have drones. All this, we have become so boring, brother. You know what I'm saying? You know, we have our swag back, and we don't say no to everything. We look to find ways of saying yes, and this is going to be amazing. Hip-hop drone show, first of its kind in our city. And I'll say it over and again, if you don't know, now you know. New York City is a city of hip-hop. Before hip-hop, black and brown music was not out in front the way it is now. It was hidden, and in many cases, like jazz, it was forbidden. Right from the start, it was about more than just music. It was a call for change, giving voice to the black and brown experience. And when the music changed, New York City changed. I am, and I'm proud to say, the first time in history, not LaGuardia, not Beam, not Koch, not de Blasio, not Bloomberg, I am the hip hop mayor. Yeah. I am the hip hop mayor. You gotta figure out the rap, because I say it all the time.
Well, come on.
You know, I'm dyslexic, I was arrested, I was rejected, now I'm elected. And this summer, we're going to do more than reminisce on hip hop. We're going to celebrate it and elevate it. So I encourage New Yorkers to step into the world where hip hop is on our blocks this summer, because this is New York. It's like it's a jungle sometimes, but this is New York City, the greatest city on the globe. Thank you, team. Let's make this happen. 50 years of hip hop. This is a hip hop, you know, that's a hip hop news person. He had a couple of hip hop. Dean is hip hop. Don't let them kid you. So, you know what I'm saying?
Don't let them kid.
You know, we got a couple of hip-hop folks here. Yeah. Listen, one of the originators in Sugar Hill Gangs, the whole crew, man. A lot of history, and we need to bring that history out into the open, and we have to go back to those pioneers so they can make paper from the industry that they created in a real way, you know? Yo, listen, you know that? I was about to pull out my medallion. Yeah, come on. You want to come on the mic, Eric B? Woo!
Eric B for president.
Eric, thank you. Thank you. But you know what, Eric? More than anything, I'd be remiss. Fred Bugs is sitting here. Fred Bugs is really responsible for us being here. We had the great record of Sugar Hill, which became a hit that everybody on radio played, but Fred Bugs played a Run DMC record and really broke through for us. And everybody, please give my brother Fred Bugs a hand. Here, my brother Peter Guns is here. We argue every day. No, don't clap for him. He's from the Bronx. We don't clap for Peter. He might get too hyped up. But thanks again, Eric Adams, for having us here. You know I got your back 110%. Everybody, thank you for coming out.
I just want to wear one of the medallions.
You can have them on.
All right. Wait. Any questions on the block parties before we bounce? That's where I got that from. Bounce. Thank you. You know, when you're out there, people are normally indoors, but back in those days, if you wanted to see and meet a shorty, you had to be on the block outside, you know? And St. Albans Parks, we used to have the live music there in St. Albans Parks. You'll go and do a block party right in the block. Folks would come out, and just enjoy themselves. And you have the DJs, you know, that was back when you carried crates of records. And the DJs would come and play, and the energy was just unreal. And it was our Hamptons. It was our Martha's Vineyards. You know, it was our way of, you know, the corner, the corner is the poor man's lounge. If we didn't have those block parties and to, you know, just really get out and engage, that was our summer retreat. And we would look forward to it. Folks would come out and play on the block. And it was just a real way for us to just enjoy a summer. You know, I hear people say all the time, we didn't even realize we were poor because we were so rich with our interaction and with the music,
right.
You know, that made us who they are. And we all could identify, all of us, you know, forget about where we are now, you know, and what we're doing right now. We go back to our roots. Those block parties made us who we are. And I'm hoping that we can re-energize some of that energy with our young people, you know, in the days ahead. So thank you. Appreciate it. Come on out.
Yeah, I'm up at Brooklyn. Now I'm down in Tri.